We want to simplify the given complex fraction. I think the best way to do this would be to find the sum of the rational expressions on top here, then find the difference of the rational expressions on the bottom here. Then once we find the sum and difference, we can write the complex fraction as a division problem, since this fraction bar does represent division. So let's go ahead and rewrite this and leave some more room horizontally. Let's also put the denominators in parentheses. One thing you have to be careful about is that it might be tempting to try to simplify this fraction over this fraction since they look the same, but we cannot do this because we cannot simplify across addition or subtraction. So looking at the top, notice how the common denominator would be the product of the quantity x plus 5 and the quantity x minus 5. So this fraction needs a factor of x minus 5 in the denominator, so we're going to multiply the fraction by the quantity x minus 5 over the quantity x minus 5. This is like multiplying by 1, so we're not changing the value. The second fraction is missing a factor of x plus 5, so we'll multiply by the quantity x plus 5 over the quantity x plus 5. Notice the common denominator at the bottom would be the same. So this first fraction is missing a factor of x minus 5. So we'll multiply by x minus 5 over x minus 5. And this last fraction here is missing a factor of x plus 5. So we'll multiply this by x plus 5 over x plus 5. Now that we have a common denominator, we can find this sum and this difference. Notice how the common denominator on top would be the quantity x plus 5 times the quantity x minus 5. Then the numerator would be the quantity x minus 5 plus the quantity x plus 5. We'll simplify this numerator in the next step. Now looking at the bottom, again we have a common denominator of the quantity x plus 5 times the quantity x minus 5. The numerator would be the quantity x minus 5 minus the quantity x plus 5. Now let's go and simplify the numerator here and here. Because we're adding, we'll just combine like terms. X plus x is 2x, and negative 5 plus 5 would be 0, so the numerator is just 2x. Now looking at the bottom, we have to be careful because we're subtracting. We would have x minus x, that's 0, and then negative 5 minus positive 5 would be negative 10. Now because this fraction bar represents division, we can write this as a division of two rational expressions. This would be the same as 2x over the quantity x plus 5 times the quantity x minus 5 divided by the fraction on the bottom. But when dividing by fractions, we normally multiply by the reciprocal. So let's go ahead and do that. The first fraction stays the same. And then instead of dividing by the second fraction, we're going to multiply by the reciprocal. So we'll have the quantity x plus 5 times the quantity x minus 5 all over negative 10. And now before we find this product, we want to simplify out any common factors between the numerators and denominators. So notice that x plus 5 over x plus 5 would simplify to 1, and so would the quantity x minus 5 over the quantity x minus 5. But also notice that 2 and 10 share a common factor of 2. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 5 2's and 10, so this would simplify to negative 5. So notice how we're left with just x over negative 5. So notice how this fraction is negative. We normally won't see a negative in the denominator. It's normally written where the negative is out front, so we have negative x over 5. Or if we want, sometimes we'll find the negative in the numerator, which is negative x over 5. These are all equivalent, but the last two are the most common way to express a negative fraction. I hope you found this helpful.